Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look at how we can install a Minecraft server inside a Kubernetes cluster. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'll just jump right into it. So the first thing we need to do is that you need to have kubectl, kubectl installed. You need to have kubectx installed. You have to have kubens installed. Those two are in the same package. I've made other videos about that. You need to have Helm 3 installed also. And you need to have, you also need to have Docker installed, because that could also be nice to try stuff out first. So, and then of course, yeah, that's actually what you need to have installed. And you also need to have Visual Studio, VS Code. You need to have VS Code installed, because I really like that to handle my YAML files. I think it's awesome for that, because it's a bit more lightweight. It's based on Atom. So it's a bit more lightweight than the products from JetBrains. I also like the products from JetBrains, but just for other purposes, like if I'm developing Python or Java, then I like those, the PyCharm and the IntelliJ. But enough about that. We have a lot of stuff to cover. When we have a Kubernetes cluster, then the ingress, for instance, that is made to route HTTP communication. So we cannot use the ingress out of the box. And we have something called, we have an ingress engine X controller that we need to configure, so it is enabled, so it can handle TCP communication. So that's the first thing that we need to do. I've already done it, but I'll show you where to do it. First of all, you go to ingress, you go to the right namespace, ingress nginx like that. And for some, yeah, so here we have, so now I'm in at this. So now I'm getting all of my deployments. When I write KGD, then it's because I have a plugin for OMYCCL, so I can just write KGD, and that means Kubernetes get deployments. So you have all of these nice aliases and shortcuts. You get those with that OMYCCL plugin. So if you enable kubectl there, then you'll get all of these awesome shortcuts. Another alias that I've made myself is K, and I will definitely recommend you. At least have that alias there if you don't want to use the plugin for OMYCCL. I would use OMYCCL, of course, if I were you. Well, here I can see I have one deployment right here. That is the ingress NGINX controller right there. I can edit by writing kubectl, kubectl, then edit, and then I can edit the deployment. Of course, I need to give the type first, deployment. Deployment like this, and then ingress nginx controller, and here this is the YAML file for my ingress nginx. It looks a bit crazy when you first open it up, but it does not matter, because you don't need to look at last applied configuration. There's a lot of these annotations in metadata you can just forget about, but that is one thing that you need to check. And that is your containers down here under specifications. And you have something called arguments for the containers. These are the arguments that the Nginx server will actually get when it starts up. And here we need that TC. We need the last two lines right here that I have my cursor on right there. We need TCP service config map. We need that, and you can set that to anything. And then it points to a config map inside a namespace, and you can have that. You can place it anywhere you want. I just chose ingress Nginx // TCP minus services. That means that inside this config map right here, that is where I configure my TCP routing. So, and the same with UDP. If you want to have some UDP routing, then you do that in that config map right there. If you just want to set up Minecraft, then you don't need to open up for UDP, so you can just forget that line right there. I just thought it was nice that now that I was in here and changing those arguments, then of course I could also change those. Let me just check right here. My keyboard is just totally, it is the English setup right now, it's not the Danish setup. I don't know, I've been actually been struggling a lot with that, and I've been uninstalling a lot of the English languages, but now I'll try to write Q and then exclamation mark, and then I hope that no changes were made. Yeah, it says no changes were made. I want to, let me just kubectl and then get that deployment -- O for YAML right there, and then I just want to check that it did not change anything at all. So, but my keyboard setup, it has been changed for some reason. But it looks fine right there. So that's good. So that's step one. And then of course we need to restart the pod, and the right way to restart a pod is actually to restart the deployment. That means you write kubectl, and then you write rollout, and you write restart, and then you write deployment. And then you write the Nginx, the Ingress Nginx controller, this one right here, and then you press enter right there. And I'll not do that because I've already done that, and then I have to wait for it to start up nicely. Then I can see that I have my pod right here, and my pod has been running for 4 days without me restarting it or anything like that. So that's I think it's a new record. So that is step one. So now you have opened up for TCP communication. Then you have to go to that config map that we just mentioned there, and I can do that by getting the config maps inside this namespace right here. And you can see I have two namespaces and two config maps, one named TCP services and one named UDP services. Let us go and edit that TCP services right there. Of course, you can also do that with YAML files with Helm 3. Actually, that's what I did in an earlier video I made with Terraria and Kubernetes. So that's why we already have it. I have created this config map inside another Helm 3 chart that we will not see. Yeah, maybe I'll show you just quickly what it looks like, but it's not part of the new stuff that we are creating tonight. So first of all, let me just go edit this config map right here, config map. And here you can see here we have the data. So we have a mapping of the port first, port 7777. It goes to my Terraria XMAS server. Then we have another Terraria server that I've set up. And then we have the default Minecraft port is 25565. And that will now then be routed to the namespace Minecraft, and then the service named Minecraft XMAS. So I have a service there named Minecraft XMAS. So that is how the routing works. And if you want to create a new Minecraft server, then you would just add something new right here. And again, now it is the. It does not matter. I cannot make a quote right now because of my keyboard setup, but that does matter. Then you'll write the port here in quotes, and then you will say where to which namespace, and then to which service that this traffic should actually end up. I'll try to see if I can quit without making any changes again right here. Let us just hope that nothing changed. No changes made. Okay, that's good. So that is the trick, and when you know that trick, then the rest is actually just basic. It's just basic Helm 3. It's just basic Kubernetes. So let us go through that. I have this Minecraft folder that I've created right here. Inside that Minecraft folder, then I have a chart.yaml file. This is where I describe what is inside this chart. All of this is a Helm 3 chart that I'm creating right here. I need to have a chart.yaml file that describes what does my chart contain. And this is Minecraft for my website, for me. And my website right now, I've named that Code Investigator. I needed a good name, but this was the name that I have right now. This is also the domain that I've bought. So Code Investigator, Minecraft, that is what we're trying to do. There's some versions right here, app version and a chart version. This chart version can be incremented, as it also says right here, by your time. And then we have some default values right here. The default values, those are very important, of course. Those are the values, if not applied through a config file or if not applied through command line, then the values in this values.yaml file here will actually be used. That means that the namespace will be set to Minecraft. The values namespace is set to Minecraft, and the port will be set to port 25565. Then I have, first of all, we need a persistent claim because we need to save the world all the time because people are making changes to the world. That is the fun part of Minecraft, that is that your users can actually change the world. They can build awesome houses, and then, of course, when you restart the server, they will start crying if you haven't saved the world. So, of course, you need a persistent claim. And this persistent claim, I'm using DigitalOcean, so this is how it looks like when you're dealing with DigitalOcean. This access mode right here, it means that I can only attach this to one to one node at a time. If I try to attach it to multiple nodes, then I'll get a lot of weird errors and my pod will not work as expected. Just so you know that read write once, and that is the default also. And right now I have a set of storage. I'm claiming 10 gigabytes. I've not checked up on how much that actually will cost me. I need to do that because sometimes I get some quite big surprises with my cloud providers. But that's another story. Here we have this persistence claim right here. I'm naming it Minecraft minus and then the site name. Whenever you want to value replace something, template something in Helm 3, then you use two of these curly brackets and then you write dot values. Then you can get access to the values. And then you can name a variable site name, for instance. And the site name is exactly what I have up in my config file up here. Then I have a site name named Xmas and a world name bees, and that is actually not needed. I don't need that. That's because I copied this file from Tar. There we needed also the world name. So right now it's just a site name. So it's just a logical name within Kubernetes that will be used in my scripts. Then I have the deployment right here, and this is actually where most of the magic actually happens. First of all, you need to use a good image. And the image right here that I've chosen to use is this one right here. Do not use the one that comes up in the top. When you search on Docker Hub, then you can search for... let me just do that. So I'll just go to hub.docker. If I search for Minecraft right here, then that is a trap. As General Akbar says... Yeah, look here, 1 million downloads, and there's this Minecraft servers by Minecraft servers. If you try to use that, at that point in time when I tried to use it, then I would get an error where it says compiled with the wrong Java version, and that it was because that it was not Java 17 compliant yet. It might be now, but this image down here, it has also been downloaded 100 million times instead. I preferred that, so it was much easier to install and use this one right here, slash Minecraft server, and that's actually, it was very easy to use. I just started up, and of course I mapped in that persistent volume, I made the volume claim, and I mapped it in the right place, and then I was actually happy. There is one thing, you can use 2 gigabytes of memory. If you do that, then it ran a little bit more smoothly in my cluster. When I took 2 gigabytes of memory, default is 1 gigabyte of memory. You need to add this EULA true. That means that you want to withhold all of the license terms and all of the interesting things that it says inside the Minecraft server license that we all have read a lot of times and we know about. That is this variable right here says that yes, I have read the license terms. But this is for the pod itself. So this means that the environment variables will actually be set to EULA true and memory 2 gigabyte. Then the Kubernetes pod also needs to be able to take the 2 gigabyte. That's what I do here. I request, it's not a limit. So we can actually, the Kubernetes can actually allow this pod to take more, the pods from this deployment to take more than 2 gigabyte, but it just requests 2 gigabyte to begin with. Maybe it's a bit of waste, I don't know. And then two things that are interested, that is needed, is TTY true and standard in true. You need those, or else you will get an error. Also, because you want to attach, when you start up your server for the first time, then you want to kubectl attach to that pod, so you can go and create your first administrator. Because then when you log on to the server, then you will start up in survival mode, and you can't do anything. And of course, you want to be an administrator, and you would go attach yourself to the main console. Then you write /op, and then you write your own name, your username, and then you will become the administrator of that server. So it means every time you log in, then you do that. You cannot block this server with a password. At least that's what I read. You cannot block it with a password like you can with Terraria, but you can whitelist. If you only have a handful of people that should be able to join your server, then you can whitelist those people. Of course, you can also kick and ban other people if you see that someone comes in and makes something that you don't like in your world. You can also set the default way to actually join the server could actually be spectator, then they cannot do anything. And since they're not administrator themselves, then they cannot change anything inside the game. Then they can just fly around and look at stuff. That's totally up to you. But this is a bit beside the point here. I'm trying to focus on how to make it work with Kubernetes, but that is just some general Minecraft tips and tricks right there. Then you have the volume mounts right here. You need to mount, for this image right here, you need to volume mount the data, //data. For other images, it's other folders. It depends on which folders they have chosen to install Minecraft in and which folders they used for their world files. And then I need to have some kind of name, Minecraft, and then I just give it the site name. I just add that. That means it will be named Minecraft minus Xmas right here. And this name right here, it needs to match this name that we have down here. There is this config volume. I think that is some legacy stuff. I'm pretty sure we don't need that anymore. That was something that I was experimenting with. Let me clean that up. We just need this volume right here. That's because I wanted to feed the reason why I had the other volume map was because I wanted to feed a config file directly into Minecraft, so I had some kind of startup settings like that people should start as spectators or whatever, or all of those things. You could, if you feed the first config file, then you can have those things to be applied to all of your Terraria servers. But I don't want to do that. Not in this setup. You can always, of course, refine your own setup, so you might get that feature. But for now, I need this volume right here to match that volume right there. And here we have the persistence volume claim that we have right here. That claim that I marked in the bottom right now, it needs to match the persistence claim that I have up here. So there's a lot of matching going on, but that's how you, if you're not new to Kubernetes, then you know that's just how it is. You have, this name here need to match that name. This claim here need to match the other claim that you saw in the persistence claim folder. And that is why I always use Helm 3 when I set up stuff in Kubernetes, because I cannot, it's really, really difficult to get a good overview of what you're actually doing. And then it's also better to have infrastructure as code instead of just going and changing something on the server. And then in 2 years, maybe then you get a new cluster and then you need to do all of those stuff again. Then we have the service. The service is also important. This service right here, this is the name of the service. That's important. And it uses a port, and this is the default port that we saw is both on the values. It's only on the values that we'll just use the default port right there. And that is fine. The target port, that is the port inside the pod running with Minecraft, and that will right now will run with the 25565 because that is the default configuration of the Minecraft server. The protocol is TCP, yes, and this is a selector. We will select all pods that has this app equals to, and then Minecraft minus Xmas right here, and that will be part of our service. So that's actually it. So how do we apply this to the cluster? First of all, make sure, always make sure that you're inside the right cluster, because sometimes you might actually be playing around with multiple clusters. Right now, I am so lucky, I only have one cluster on this setup on this machine right here. So I'm always on the right cluster, so to say. So make sure that you're on the right cluster. Then I would actually recommend that you always create a shell script file so you can run a shell script instead of running a command. A command disappears whenever you close down your terminal, but a shell script is there, infrastructure as code. Yes, it is good. So apply Minecraft right there. I have made the shell script right here. First, I clear the console. Don't want any clutter in my terminal. Then I go to the current folder name, the current directory. Then I make sure that I'm on the right Kubernetes context on the right cluster. And then I make sure that I'm in the right namespace also. The reason why I need to do that, even though I have the... Okay, I need to tell you a funny story here, because even though you actually have the namespace inside your Helm 3 files, because you can see here, I actually have namespace up here. Namespace is actually set right there. If you are applying it from a different namespace the next time, then you'll get an error. Then the Helm 3 is so smart that it will actually say, hey, you installed this from maybe the Ingress Nginx namespace because you forgot that you actually placed yourself inside that inside that namespace the last time, and then the next time you try to run, you try to apply the script, the Helm tree chart from another namespace, then the Kubernetes will actually reject that because the namespace from where you run your Helm tree upgrade, or it will actually be stored as metadata on the deployment itself. I will show you this inside my Kubernetes cluster in just a minute. But the command is Helm tree upgrade, and then even though it's the first time that you're actually installing this chart, then you should still use upgrade, because along with the -- install, then it would actually install this chart because it is the first time that it runs on your cluster. This is the logical name of your chart. This is the location. This is the folder location for your chart. Because I'm in the parent directory, then this folder right here is .dot, and then Minecraft. That is where I placed my Helm tree scripts. And this is where now it gets interesting, because now you can actually apply configuration files. That means you can have different environments. If I want to set up a new Minecraft server, then I could just create a new config file with a new site name, and then I could just have a new Minecraft server that I could then of course route the traffic to also, and then it would just be by changing this file right here and creating a new config file. Then I have -- debug. That's because I wanted to spray out in the log what is going on, what did actually change. This is actually it. It is quite easy when you know how to do it as usual. The most difficult part for me was to know that that I needed to route the traffic to this service right here, and I had to enable TCP. There's another thing: if you want to use the launcher, the Microsoft, they're trying to trick you into converting your account into a Microsoft account, and I was so stupid that I actually did that. So it means that I have to log on with my Microsoft account every time. It limits me to only to be able to play on. It does not limit me, but it just pisses me off, because when I'm running Windows 11 and I still have to download and use the Java launcher, and I have to choose I had to install the Java launcher for Windows 8 and 9. The latest and greatest did not work. It just said, it gave me the error that your account does not match your Windows account or something like that. That was really, really annoying. So I could not even start it up. So here is the Java launcher right there. Latest and greatest version right there. Then you just press play. Yeah, I like the Microsoft operating system, and then all the drivers and all that. It always just works out of the box. I don't have to struggle with that. Just like if I'm running a clean Ubuntu installation, then there's always some drivers that doesn't work as it should, or maybe the fan on my PC, maybe it just it just starts turning around too much compared to how much it's actually doing and stuff like that. There's a lot of stuff that doesn't work out of the box with Ubuntu, that just works with Windows. So I really like that, but you can really feel all the corporate stuff that they try to stuff down your throat all the time. It is really, really annoying. But here I have my server right here. Let's see if I can join it. Yes, here it is. It looks awesome, and then because I'm administrator, then I can say game mode, and then I can say right now I'm in creative. I could also say survival. I'm in survival mode, or of course then I fell. Yeah, that's how it is. Respawn. Let's see where we can respawn, and here we are. So now I'm playing Tire. That's actually what I wanted to show you. I hope you got something out of this demonstration right here. Feel free to leave a comment. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again very soon. Bye bye.